Investigation of a singly reinforced rectangular concrete beam using NSCP 2015. Hello, this is De La Cruz Engineering video tutorial, and in this lecture, as the title shows, we will be investigating the flexural strength of a rectangular concrete beam, okay, according to the code of NSCP 2015. So these are the topics included. So in this video, we will learn how to use the reduction factor that is given by the NSCP 2015 code, and we will also learn how to compute the design moment VMN of rectangular singly reinforced beam. Okay, without any further ado, let's start to solve the problem. Okay, so disclaimer muna, these problems are from these books. Okay, this book is the Simplified Reinforced Concrete by DIT Gilesanya. So this is one of my favorite books when I am preparing my board exam. Okay, so anyway, let's proceed. So determine the design moment capacity of the beam. If it is reinforced with 525 mm tension steel bars. So what's the first step here? Okay, so the first step talaga sa concrete or kahit sa mga beam problems is to locate the neutral axis. Okay, so that is the main purpose, the main focus natin at first view sa concrete. Okay, now, looking the beam at the side view at a cut portion, ito yung makikita natin. And we will project that. And let's assume the neutral axis is andito. Okay, and the neutral axis is distance from the extreme compression fiber to that point. Okay, and that is denoted as small c. Okay, now the effective compression of the concrete is somewhere above the neutral axis. Okay, and that is parallel to the it will form a line parallel to the neutral axis. And it is also in the code, no? Pinakita ko yan from my previous video. Okay. Now this depth here is the effect the depth of compression block, and that is denoted as A. And that is the same dito. And ito yung relationship ng A and C. We have the beta 1 factor. And this is also in the code ren. Okay? So from that, the stress here will be evenly distributed dito. Okay, and that is just 0.85 Fc prime. Okay, and of course, the stress will create a resulting force, and that is the compression of the concrete. Okay, and that is called as capital C. And that is force. It is just stress times area. Okay, where the stress is 0.85 Fc prime, and the area is A times B. Okay, the effective compression. Well, in this case, A times B yan because it is rectangular beam. Okay. Now, in order to account this force, it will be countered by the tensile force of the steel reinforcement. Okay, and that is denoted as T. And that is also stress times area lang, where stress is Fs and area is As. Okay, because these force are not collinear and that is parallel force, it will create a couple moment, and that is called as the nominal moment capacity of the beam. Okay, now this part here is just half of the A, the effective compression block. Okay, because that is evenly distributed nga, yung resulting force mo is acting at the centroid lang nito. Okay, therefore the remaining distance here is just the depth minus this half of A. Okay, that is D minus A over 2. So basically the moment is just the force times distance. If we'll take moment about T, that is the compression force times this distance. Or otherwise, if we'll take moment about C, that is just T times this distance the same. Okay? They have the same results lang. Kahit ano yung gamitin mo, the C or the tension. Okay? So, how to do this? First, we will equate the tension force and compression force to maintain equilibrium, di ba? Dapat equal sila. Okay, now, using these forces here, that is AS, FS yung tension, and the compression naman is ito, 0.85 FC prime AB. No? Now, AS here is given, so may binigay na limang bakal, 25 mm daw. So, calculating that first, ito yung AS natin, 2454 millimeter squared. Now, the question here is, ano yung FS natin? Okay? So, ganito yung gagawin natin. Let's assume na tension steel yields. And that is just the actual stress natin dapat mas malaki sa yielding strength, which is the Fy. Ito, 345. No? And if we'll do that, we will assume Fs here as 345 lang. Because hindi dapat dumagpas sa yielding strength yung gagamitin natin sa equilibrium equation. Okay? Pag lumagpas dyan, meaning masisira na yung steel natin. So, ito yung limitation ng force natin na gagamitin. Okay? So, using this Fy, ito yung mangyayari. Equating. So, by the way, Fc prime here is 21 megapascal. Okay? So, as you see, A can be solved. You can use shift solve here. 153 millimeters. And kasunod dyan, if masosolve natin yung A, diretso na makuha si C because of this relationship. Okay? So, that is just 153 over 0.85. By the way, beta 1 here is 0.85 because that is 21 megapascal yung Fc prime natin. Okay? So, pinakita ko ito sa code from my previous video. So, tingnan nyo na lang sa link dito mamaya. So, that is in the code, ha? 0.85. So, that is our C is 180 millimeters. Now, after we solve our C, we will compute the actual stress of this steel, which is the Fs, by using this formula. Okay? Because after that, we will prove if this is truly happening, okay? The tension steel yields. And if we substitute the value here, D is 500 and C is 180, our Fs daw, or the actual stress of this steel, is 1067 megapascal. And as you see, this is truly greater than Fy. So, nag-yield talaga yung steel natin. Therefore, our assumption is correct. And our solution is correct also from the start. And we can proceed. Okay? Now, if we have the value of C, we can actually solve the MN na, no? By using this. So, pwede rin itong gamitin mo. But I would rather use this because my area of steel naman tayo. So, mas madali siyang ilagay. No? So, here, substitute, T is ASFY. So, take note, nag-yield siya. So, FY talaga yung gagamitin natin. Hindi ito. Okay, by substituting, ito yung lalabas na nominal moment strength capacity, 358.55. Now, the question here is the design moment capacity, that is the VMN. Now, since the actual stress Fs is greater than 1000 MPa, our reduction factor, according to this code, this is the table that is given in NSCP 2015, no? In this case, tingnan nyo, ipakita natin by stresses. Okay? Dito, nilagay nila according to the strains. Well, I showed here the relationship according to the stresses. Okay? So, pinakita ko rin ito sa part 1 of my video on designing a rectangular beam. So, tingnan nyo dito sa link na ito. Okay? So, tingnan nyo. Yung Fs natin is lumagpas sa 1,000 MPa. So, tingnan nyo sa table. Fs is greater than 1,000 MPa, so somewhere here. So meaning, if we locate that to our reduction factor, the reduction factor must be 0.9 lang. This is constant dito. Okay? So from here, we will use reduction factor phi as 0.9. Okay? So our design moment capacity phi mn is just 0.9 times that value. And this is the answer. 322.7 kilonewtons meter. Okay? Ayun. So, the next problem, what if magdagdag tayo ng reinforcing dito? Gawin natin siyang 6. Okay? Ano yung mangyayari sa reduction factor natin? Okay. The same solution pa rin. Equate T and C and gawin ito. Then, compute the tension steel bars. To naging 2945 na siya. Then, assuming tension steel yields and Fs is greater than Fy. Okay? Again, substituting that. Ito yung mangyayari. Then, masasolve natin yung A. The same solution lang sa part 1. Then, compute C and solving C, that is 216.03. Then, we'll prove this assumption by calculating the actual stress. Then, the actual stress here is 788.67 megapascal. And that is greater to our Fy. Okay? Therefore, the assumption is correct. Okay. But, actually, in the code, hindi sinabi niya na dapat hindi parang dinidiscourage ng code na hindi dapat lumiit sa 800 megapascal yung Fs natin. Okay? So, from the code kasi sinabi na if liliit sa 800 megapascal yung Fs, we will design the beam as doubly reinforced. Okay? But here, we are investigating the flexural strength. Hindi tayo nagdi-design dito. Alangan namang wag natin gamitin, hindi natin gagamitin yung bakal na nandyan, na mismo sa concrete. No? So, ito yung mangyayari. May alternative yung NSCP dito if hindi siya lumagpas sa 800 megapascal. Okay? So, from here muna, no? Let's proceed muna na assuming the tension steel yields and that is okay. So, we can solve our Mn by T times D minus A over 2. The same pa rin kanina. We substitute. And our Mn is 414.76 kilonewtons meter. Now, the question here is the reduction factor. Okay? So, ito yung alternative ng NSCP. Pag hindi siya lumagpas sa 1,000 MPa and 800 megapascal. Tingnan nyo. This is the scenario. Our Fs is greater than Fy, but our Fs is lesser than 1,000 MPa. So, can we use this reduction factor as 0.9? Okay, tingnan natin ulit yung code. So, ito yun. Ito na lang yung gagamitin natin in terms of stresses. So, our Fs daw is in between Fy to 1,000 MPa. Well, if we locate our reduction factor here, that is variable in terms of this formula. Therefore, our reduction factor cannot be 0.9 na because of this scenario. Okay? Because of this stress. Now, we will use this formula to compute the reduction factor na. Okay? So, tingnan nyo. By using that formula, is substitute mo lang. So, Fs here is 766.67. So, I'm sorry, parang namali ko ang nasulat dito. Naging 788. Okay, so this is 766.67 dapat ha, yung Fs. Minus Fy 345 divided by 1000 minus Fy. That is 0.819. Okay, so ito lang yung sinasabi sa code. Tingnan mo itong graph na ito. Then, ilocate mo yung Fs, actual Fs mo dyan. Then, after that, makukonclude mo na yung reduction factor mo. So, ito yung alternative sa code. No? Pag hindi siya naging lumagpas sa 800 MPa, so because of this, paliliitin ang capacity niya. So, this is for this formula, but actually, we can use our calculator here. Tingnan nyo. gagamitin natin yung calculator, and that can be solved by mode. Hanapin yung stat and linear. Linear, no? So, ito yung gagawin mo. When x is fy and fy is 345, our y is, what is our y here? That is 0.65. Now, when our x is 1000 megapascal, from here that is 1000 megapascal, our y daw is 0.9. Okay? 0.9. Okay? And pressing CA dito, then ups, then hanapin mo yung, saan ba dito? Distribution, variance, so, sa 5 bata. Mali. So, balik ko ha. Ups, then 7. Mali rin. So, ngayon ko lang nakita kasi ito, nagamit. Saan ba dito ha? Regression pala. So, sa regression. No? So, we will use here the y hat. Okay. Ano yung magiging reduction factor mo when fs is 766.87? So, 766.67. Okay? And press equals. So, ito yung lalabas. 0.808109. So, 8109 pala ito. Okay? Paki-correct lang. 8109. No? So you can use linear mode dito sa calculator to solve that reduction factor if nasa boundary na ito. Okay? So after that, if we have the reduction factor, we can solve the design strength, and that is the answer here. Okay? So what if palakihin pa natin ito? Lalagyan natin yan ng siyam na bakal. Okay? Gagawin nating 9. So, ano yung mangyayari sa reduction factor mo? So, tingnan mo ha. The same solution. Ayan. Then, calculating AS. Then, assuming tension still yields pa rin. Dapat FY plus AS. Then, substituting the values here. Ito yung makukuha nating A. And ito yung makukuha nating C. Then, improved by using this FS formula. Then, ito yung magiging FS. No? As you see, that is lesser than FY, which is mali sa assumption natin. Okay? So, the assumption not satisfied. So, ano yung mangyayari dito? That means that these solutions here are all wrong. Mali yan. So, ganun yun sa design. First, you make an assumption. Then, if i-prove mo yung assumption, then if your assumption is correct, we will proceed to the solution. If our assumption is wrong, then revise our solution. Okay? So, in this case, mali yung assumption natin. So, i-revise talaga natin yung solution natin. So, since mali yun, so, assuming tension still doesn't yield na tayo. Okay? And that is Fs is lesser than Fy. No? And we will use Fs here as 600 D minus C over C. Ito na yung gagamitin nating Fs. Okay, so tingnan nyo. Substituting here, ito yung mangyayari. So our AS here is 4118. Our FS is itong formula na to. And 0.85 FC prime. And our A here is beta 1 C. Okay, beta 1 is 0.85. And C and B. And as you can see, the unknown here is the C, the distance of the neutral axis. No? So, using our calculator here, that is 319.2. Then, susunod dyan yung A natin, beta 1C. So, that is 271.32. Okay? Now, we will prove our assumption. So, using this formula again, substitute. And that is truly lesser than 345 megapascal. So, our assumption here is correct. Meaning, we can proceed to our solution na. Diba? So, proceed tayo dito. Mn is equal to T times D minus A over 2. Then, substitute. our Mn is 547 megapascal. Okay? Since Fs is lesser than Fy, that is 345, so according to this code, no? Your Fs here is lesser to this Fy. So somewhere andito siya, no? So our reduction factor dito is fixed at 0.65. Okay? So the design moment here is 0.65 times 547 and ito yung lalabas. That will be the answer. So ito lang yung mga cases kung saan nagbabari yung reduction factor natin. Pinakita natin lahat. Okay? So ayun lang, that's it. I hope you learned something, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe my channel and please like, share to your CE friends, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Okay? So God bless everyone and stay safe.